Hallo, hallo, Mic Test. So you can see some target price and the stop loss like this. So it's working absolutely fine. It's having a long here, which is a long position, and then it is getting exited here, which is perfect. You can see that this strategy is a profit-making strategy. The net profit is 82.49%. The drawdown is like this, and you can see this. We have made a profit-making strategy by writing only these few lines of the code. I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you are interested to build a TradingView Pine Script buy sell strategy, then you're at the right place. This video is for the beginners, and if you want to learn how to make a trading strategy and backtest it on TradingView platform using Pine Script, then watch this video till the end. I'll show you step-by-step procedure in the easiest way possible on YouTube. And before jumping to the code, if you are new to my YouTube channel, on this channel I turn all my viewers to a successful financial programmer. On this channel I have made videos related to trading bots, this entire tutorial series on TradingView. I have made videos on implementation of AI in finance, some highly valuable finance APIs, etc, etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then just click on that red button down below and also hit on the bell icon. And then just leave everything on me. I'll change your life. Shout out to my Patreon member Edmund. And if you are interested to explore my Patreon page, which is an exclusive community, then just watch this video till the end. I'll tell you what all things you can expect on that exclusive community. Now let's jump to the topics to cover in this video. We'll start by building a strategy using multiple technical indicators, and for this I'll be using two types of indicators. First one is EMA, which is exponential moving average, and the second one would be a mix of RSI and MFI. If you remember, in the last video we made our own technical indicator by mixing these two technical indicators, and now I'll be using this one to make a trading strategy. Then after that we'll see how to implement stop loss and target value. We'll plot some graphs, and then in the end we'll analyze all the results that we have got. So I'll start with this one. I'm actually recording this video at 1:18 in the morning, because in India this time US market is working, so you can see the changes in price of Apple. So let's go. I'm writing this code on version 5, so I'll keep the first line. I'll have to change this to strategy. And this, I have given some inputs here. The name of this strategy is simple strategy. The overlay is equal to true because I want the plot to be on the graph. That's why I have kept it is equal to true. Anyways, it does not impact the trading strategy, but just for the visualization, I have kept it this equal to true. The capital, initial capital is equal to $100,000. And if you remember, the last video also explained the default quantity type. It would be strategy dot percent of equity. Let me maximize this window. Now we'll start with EMA, which is exponential moving average. For this, I would actually put an input requirement for the length that would be required for the EMA calculation. So let's start with EMA input one. So is equal to input dot int. This is used to have an input which is an integer. And then let's say the default is 200, which can be changed. I'll show you how. And the name is EMA length, right? Let's just plot close, right? For example, let me minimize this. And if I press Control S, it will ask me to give a name here. Just simple strategy video 3, right? So this, if I just press Control S, if you go here, if you hover it over here and just click on this gear sign, you'll see that input length is of 200 has been mentioned here, which you can change it to 300, for example, or something else as well. Right now the idea is I am actually providing this input to the user such that the user can change it accordingly to make the strategy as per his or her will. Right, EMA is equal to TA dot EMA. If I hover over on it, we just need to provide source and length. Source is close and length is EMA input. Perfect. Now we can actually draw EMA line here. So I'll just replace close with EMA. Now the trading logics, if I just write trading logic, would be EMA by condition is equal to when EMA is less than close. So whenever the EMA is less than close, we'll say it's a buy signal, and whenever the EMA is greater than close, it's a sell signal, right? So it will be a boolean. It will be true or false here. So if it's less than close, it will be true here, right, which will be a buy condition. It's a simple strategy. Similar to this, I'll just copy and paste it here and replace with sell and change it to greater than. So this is the first logic that I'm going to use to make the strategy. We are not just making our trading strategy using just one indicator. We are going to use the indicator that we made in our last video as well, if you remember. So I'll just copy and paste that code here, right, like this. And for my new viewers who have not watched my last video, I'll just very quickly skim it through it. So basically what I'm doing here is I am calculating RSI, right? Through all these calculations, you can see the RSI value is calculated here in the end. And then I'm using MSI indicator, which is actually, it's not MSI, it's MFI, which is money flow index indicator here, which is like this. And then in the end, I'm making our own indicator, which is RSI MFI, which is an average of both of them, right? The buy condition is when it is greater than or equal to 70. The sell condition is when it is less than or equal to 40. Perfect. So we have got two buy and two sell conditions. We'll have to mix it them. So whenever the buy condition satisfy both the our RSI and MFI indicator and the EMA indicator, then only it will buy, and the same with the sell as well. Now just make some logics on the stop loss and target price. So let's suppose that the stop loss is at 10% of the price. And change it again, like, because we can change it, we'll have to provide it as an input. So yeah, over here, what I've done here is percentage based input float. Now it can be in decimals, so that's why float, not integer. 10% is the default value that I provided, which I can change it in the input in the gear section, if you remember. The percentage multiplier is the title name. The minimum value is 0, step would be 0.5. The R ratio, which is the risk reward ratio, all the trading lovers would know this thing. But yeah, for the people who don't have much trading exposure, the risk reward ratio is basically the ratio of the level of the target price and the level of the stop loss. So at the beginning, let's keep it as 2, which is the risk reward ratio here. And then again, the minimum value is equal to 0, the steps of 0.5. So yeah, stop loss amount would be simple calculation of close multiplied by percent based divided by 100. Now we'll have to remember the candle at which the any sort of trading is happening, like buy or sell. So in order to do that, we will write a couple, like 3-4 lines here, which will actually remember the candle of any trading action, right? So for that, let's start with the buy and then I'll come to the sell. So yeah, if the bot buys any particular say quantity, the position size, the last position size would be greater than the position size before that, right? So in this situation, bot would be a boolean, which is a true or false. Now in order to capture the bar, since we bought it, I've just write it since entry long, which is TA dot bar since and then bot. So it will remember the candle on which the buy action has been taken. And similar to this, we'll do it for the selling as well. So yeah, I have written these two lines as well, which is sold. Again, in this case, it should be less than this one. And this is bar TA dot bar since and then sold. Now I just provided some, I would say some numbers to some of the variables that I'm going to use. So the first one is the price stop long, which is equal to 0. Price stop short is equal to a very big number. Suppose like this would be somewhere around 10 or 100 billion or 100 billion. The target value long is 0. Target value short, stop value long, stop value short is equal to 0. I want to have a stop loss, which is not trailing. It will be exactly the same. If you want to if you want me to make a video on trailing stop loss and something else as well, just like write it on the comment section and I'll make those videos as well. But in this one, let's just keep it very simple. So the stop loss is not trailing, it will be straight. The target price will also not be trailing, it will also be exactly straight. So if strategy dot position size is greater than 0, which is it has bought some quantity, then stop value long is equal to close minus stop loss amount. Stop loss amount is the amount that we calculated here. Close is this one. And then now we have changed our value of stop value long from 0 to this one. And similar to this one, the price stop long would be, like, what is the price? Would be close since we have bought it, and then minus stop loss amount since we have bought it. So it will always be the same, right? This is the main idea, because the the close price since we bought it and the stop loss amount since we bought it would be exactly the same all the time. So it will always be the same number, and that's why we will have a straight line for stop loss. And similar to this, I have provided the target value long as well, which is close since entry plus close since entry multiplied by the percentage change multiplied by the risk reward ratio. If you remember, it's the ratio, the extent of the target price and then the extent of the stop loss. That's why we have already provided the risk reward ratio, and this one would be giving us the value of the target value. Again, I'm using since entry, and since entry should be since entry long, and here also since entry long. So it will always be the same, so it will be a straight line as well. Else keep the price stop long as to be equal to zero only. I have done the exact same thing for the short position as well. So if the strategy position size is less than zero, which is at has the short position active, in that case the stop value short is equal to close plus stop loss amount, and then the price would be this plus this, and then target value in this case would be close since entry short minus close since entry short multiplied by percentage base divided by 100 multiplied by risk reward ratio, as we have done in the this line. And again, if it is not less than zero, then in that case the price stop short should be equal to something big, right? A very big amount. Now let's execute the trades. So if you are not writing this code while watching this one this video, don't worry, I'll save this code on my Google Drive, and all my already existing subscribers know that I share my Google Drive access for free. For my new viewers, if you want to get a free access of my Google Drive, you just need to click on the subscribe button, and over there you can find this link of access to my Google Drive. Just click on that. After that, just follow some basic steps over there, and then click on this link of Google form and just provide some basic details. After that, you can just copy and paste this code for your personal usage. Not only this code is available, there are many more codes available in the Google Drive, and it is being used by more than 2000 people already. Just follow the steps and get all these things for free. Okay, so we have two trading logics, if you remember. If the first one is the EMA, if this EMA, I just copied it and I'll just provide it in the bracket, if EMA is equal to true, and the second one was this one, this should also be equal to true, then strategy.entry, and let me just write long, strategy.long quantity is equal to say 1000, and only when strategy.position size is less than equal to zero. And similarly, if EMA sell condition is equal to true and the RM sell condition is equal to true, then the strategy dot entry short, strategy dot short quantity is 1000, again when the strategy dot position size should be greater than equal to zero. Now guys, stop loss and target price trading logics, which would be strategy dot exit. Let's start with long exit from entry, which one, which is this one, long. I'll just copy and paste it here. Right, so what I'm doing here is I'm like naming it, the title is long exit, but I'm using from entry of long. So if this one is already executed, then only this will be activated. So if this is so it will take it from here, and if I hover over it, and you can see all these inputs are required. So from entry quantity is required, which will be the same quantity, percentage, profit, limit order is important here, stop order is important. So yeah, I'll write each and everything one by one. So let's start with limit is equal to the target value long one. We calculated the target value long one here. This is the limit order, the target price. For the stop loss, we'll just write stop is equal to the price stop long when is equal to strategy dot position size is greater than zero. Similar to this, I'll just copy and paste it here. For short exit, I'll just write short exit here to be short. This should be target short, target value short, stop is price stop short, and this would be less than zero. Now let's plot all these things. So yeah, the first one P1 is equal to plot. It will actually check if the price stop long is greater than zero. Then it means that we have long position active and we need to show the stop loss in the target price. So if it is greater than zero, then we will show the stop loss, which is price stop long. Otherwise, we will not show anything, which is NA. And let's name it as SL, stop loss long. Color would be color dot purple, right? The style would be this one, style underscore line BR. Similar to this one, if the price stop long is greater than zero, which again means that we have an active long position, the target value long is displayed here. If it is not active, then we will show NA, which is nothing. And the name is target long. The color here is color dot aqua. Similar to this one, we will plot P3, which is price. If the price stop short is less than this big number, then in that case, we just show price stop short, otherwise NA, because if it is less than this big number, then it means that we have a short position active. That's why we need to show the stop loss and the target price in the short position as well. The color here is again purple, because for the stop loss, we are using purple color, and similar to that, we are using the target value short and the color would be aqua. So let me just save this code. If I just add it to the chart, like this, let me remove this one. You can see over here the results of this strategy, right? On the chart, you can see some trades, right? Let me just zoom it like this. You can see some target price and the stop loss. So it's working absolutely fine. It's having a long here, which is a long position, and then it is getting exited here, which is perfect. It is the loss making strategy, but yeah, again, we are not here to make profit making strategy. I'm more focused for you to learn how to make your own strategy, and definitely we can play with the numbers and we can put more things to make it profitable. The main idea here is to have this number as high as possible, and the profit factor is also very important, which considers both the profit and the drawdown value. You can see the maximum drawdown in this case was 46.79%, but if I just like open it like this, you can see the entire graph of all these things, which you can see, and there are just 25 trades that were closed. Now, in order to play with the numbers, let me just do it like this, and you can like over this gear function, you can just change all these numbers here. If you remember, we provided all these different parameters here. So I'll just, what I'm gonna do here is I'll just change this to say 200 EMA, and wow, I just changed this to 200 EMA, and the strategy has become a profit making strategy, right? You can see that you can do a lot of things here. And the length, let's just do it to 20, and over here I'm the MA length to be 10, right? The stop loss percentage to be say 8%, and the risk reward ratio to be equal to 2.5, right? I'm just providing some random numbers here. I'll just press OK here. You can see that this strategy is a profit making strategy, and the net profit is 82.49% with a profit factor of 1.8 factor. The drawdown is like this, and you can see this, that we have made a profit making strategy by writing only these few lines of the code. Making a profit was not a motive of this tutorial video, but I hope that you have got an idea. Now, if you are interested to get some exclusive services that I provide on exclusive community on Patreon, things like discussing some trading strategies, or if you have some doubts on Python, etc., if you want to connect with me directly, then consider to be a part of my Patreon community. And if you watch this video till the end, then I just deserve at least one like, guys. Spare 1 second for me, just click on that like button, because it is very, very important for algorithm. And also comment what all types of different trading strategies that you want me to cover here on this channel. You can click on this video if you want to watch how I created a successful trading bot strategy, and you can click over there if you want to learn how to use Talib library, which is technical analysis library, to do some technical analysis on Python. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. Keep exploring, keep learning.